It's Tuesday, November 12th, 2013. This is the International Space Station Flight Control Room. Welcome to Space Station Live on this day, the first day following Veterans Day, and also the arrival and departure of three crew members at the International Space Station. This flight control team today is being led by veteran flight director Ed Van Cise. He's joined by Mark Reagan, you see to his right. He's serving as the spacecraft communicator, the communications link between Houston and the crew aboard the International Space Station. That crew, currently six, went from six to nine and back to six, and all in the span of about 6 days, with the departure of three crew members after 166 days in space. And they left behind this six-member crew that you see under command of Oleg Kotov, Russian cosmonaut, as a commander of Expedition 38 now aboard the International Space Station. He's joined by Sergei Ryazansky and U.S. astronaut Mike Hopkins there on the right side of the crew logo. On the left side, the three newest arrival crew members having arrived just a few days ago, 6 days in fact, Mikhail Turin, Rick Mastracchio, and Koichi Wakata, representing the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. So a multinational crew that makes up six crew members aboard the station. Three crew members have been there 48 days, the newest three, 6 days now. And then inside the U.S. laboratory, as crew members, the three newest crew members, spend some time throughout their day acclimating themselves to the new environment of living in space rather than just visiting for short duration missions. You see Mike Hopkins and Rick Mastracchio, they are working directly with the ground on the water recovery management system, the condensate pumping system, as part of that elaborate, intricate environmental control and life support system of the International Space Station. It's not malfunctioning. They are basically in the process of activating a high-flow fluid transfer pump that's designed to transfer fluid from the to the wastewater bus system. Power is provided from one of the what's known as express racks aboard the station. And so they've been working with that for a short period of time in the second half of their day aboard the station. This is in the laboratory of the or actually a little further back than the laboratory in the Harmony module of the International Space Station, just where the connecting point to the European Laboratory Columbus and the Japanese Laboratory Kibo is located. In the far distance, you see stowage bags against what is known as a pressurized mating adapter. That is a basically a docking port that's currently not required for any visiting vehicle traffic. The six crew members of Expedition 38 are in great shape, and they have been working since midnight U.S. Central Time, and they'll go to bed about 3:30 in the afternoon Central Time as well. Throughout the day, the crew members divide and conquer with some experiment work, some adaptation training for getting acclimated to their new environment, and obviously conducting some daily planning conferences with the ground and their routine exercise plans as they get well acquainted with one another for the next roughly 3 months or so.